In this video tutorial, we're going to demonstrate some of the more powerful features of digital music production with sampler instruments, in particular articulations and key switching. Here in my DAW, I have a sampler instrument I've loaded up to a violin patch. I've chosen a violin simply because stringed instruments have so many different articulations. You'll notice in the keyboard display at the bottom of the sampler window, there are non-colored keys that represent the playable notes, orange keys which aren't used, and a set of blue keys here in the lower register that are my key switches. Now, these key switches won't actually play a sound, but rather they will allow me to switch between my articulations. Keep in mind, not all samplers or instrument patches will have or support articulation and key switching abilities, much less provide this handy keyboard display. Some may implement articulations in a very different manner, while others may not include them at all. Jumping over to my control view, you'll notice this particular sampler has an articulation list that shows all of the available articulations for the instrument. In this case, there's over 20 of them. Over on the right-hand side of the list, along with the abbreviated descriptions, you'll notice it also shows the corresponding note name of the key switch that triggers that articulation, be it C0 or C-sharp 0, D0, and so forth. So if I go ahead and press the C0 key switch, I'll have my basic sustained vibrato articulation for the violin, which I can play using any of the regularly colored notes. I'm using my mouse here as well as my MIDI keyboard to help demonstrate, but you could just as easily play the key switches on your MIDI keyboard itself. If I press the F0 key switch, you can see that corresponds to the tremolo articulation. And when I play a note, you can hear that this has changed. The E0 key switch takes you to a more lyrical legato, as they call it here, which you'll notice is a bit more dynamic and expressive than the very first sustained articulation we played. Other key switches take you through a variety of staccato articulations, often well suited for playing short, fast notes in succession. And of course, no stringed instrument is complete without a nice pizzicato pluck. Just as actual violinists will change back and forth in their playing and bowing style from legato to staccato to other articulations as the musical score requires, the key switches allow you to emulate that dynamic playing style by triggering the articulations as you need them. Let's take a look at how this might work in a piece of music. Here I have two violin parts sequenced in my DAW. This first version here doesn't utilize any of the key switches or articulations, simply set to the basic sustained vibrato we heard first. Let's take a listen to how it sounds. In this second version, I've added some key switches at various points throughout the playing. You can see them there in the lower register of the piano roll. You can also watch the keyboard display in the sampler window to see the notes and key switches as they're played together. Let's listen to the difference. Thank you. I think you'll agree, being able to switch between articulations on the fly really helps enhance the realism and dynamic of the virtual performance. That's all for this demonstration. As a final thought, just take a moment to consider all of the effort and attention to detail that must have gone into the recording and preparation of these instrument samples, as well as the degree of management and control over these sample audio files that the sampler system itself has to exercise to provide this kind of seamless and dynamic playing experience. You can find more information on getting the most out of your digital music productions in Chapter 8 of the text. Thanks for watching.